All right. Great movie scene. Unknown actor. All right. Oh, yeah. I was talking about this is a new topic here where I was talking about actors that you saw just do like five lines in a fucking movie and they absolutely destroyed it. And you and your friends still quote them. You don't even know their fucking name.
This shit wasn't even clean, man.
Déjalo, güero. What's your problem, mister?
I paid for a full load, man.
Don't worry. We'll take care of business.
Don't worry. Sick, motherfucker.
Make sure he gets what he ordered right now.
Simon.
Thank you. I fucking appreciate that, man.
I brought up that guy last week, the guy from Pulp Reservoir Dogs. The guy in, you know, when Tim Roth's character is, what is he? He's in the fucking bathroom, and that cop's telling that story. I said, buddy, I am going to shoot you in the face. You don't put your fucking hands in that dashboard. Love that guy. So here he goes. One of my favorite scenes with an unknown actor was Kill Bill 2. Bill's brother, Bud. I wish I need to see these movies to do this justice. I mean, I saw this, but I don't remember it. She wore the same outfit, that fucking yellow outfit in both movies, didn't she? Bill's brother, Bud, is working as a bouncer at a rundown strip club. He shows up late for work, gets called into his boss's office. His boss, Larry Gomez, is played by actor Larry Bishop, and he looks like half a wolf man. After doing a line of blow with a haggard-looking stripper, oh, I vaguely remember this, he levels his gaze at Bud and says, I don't know what car wash you worked before you came here that let you stroll in 20 minutes late, but it wasn't owned by you. It wasn't owned by me, and I own a fucking car wash.
I don't know what car wash you worked before you came here that let you stroll in 20 minutes late, but it wasn't owned by me, and I own a fucking car wash.
I just butchered that line. People, I can't read. I've realized that I need glasses and I have slight dyslexia. I was trying to write squawk today and I knew all the letters and I just could not remember. So I was trying to remember what squawking 7,700 versus 7,500. I always get those two mixed up. If that's an emergency landing or a fucking hijacking, I was, because one's stay alive and the other is fucking go to heaven. All right. Sorry, that's how you remember it. 75, stay alive. 77, go to heaven. All right? 75 is hijacking. 77 is emergency. And 76, need a fix, means your fucking radio is out. This doesn't mean anything to you guys. I don't know what car wash you worked before you came here that let you stroll in 20 minutes late, but it wasn't owned by me, and I own a fucking car wash. There you go. That was a good fucking read. That makes me want to go see that movie. He then proceeded to give this world-class assassin a humiliating dress-down, telling him he's as useless as an asshole on his elbow and crossing off all his scheduled work days on the calendar.
What are you trying to convince me of exactly? That you're as useless as an asshole right here? Well, guess what, buddy? I think you just fucking convinced me.
He finishes by telling him never to wear his cowboy hat to work and has him cleaned a clogged toilet on his way out. All Bud can do is stand there and take it.
That fucking hat. How many times have I told you? Don't wear that fucking hat here. How many?
I hope you've seen this great movie. If not, it's worth a watch. Thanks and go fuck yourself. I'm going to go watch it again. All right. I think this bit is going to make people go see these cool movies again, and it's also going to make everybody laugh at how bad I can't fucking read out loud. All right, Bill, my favorite line in a comedy ever might be from Blazing Saddles, delivered by Slim Pickens. He rides into the scene where his workers are singing Camtown Races, and says, "What in the wide, wide world? A sport is going on here. I urge you people to try to get a little track laid, not to jump around like a bunch of Kansas City faggots."
What in the wide, wide world of sports is going on here? I urge you people to try to get a little track laid, not to jump around like a bunch of Kansas City faggots.
I remember that line. Whatever the hell that means. And I'm quoting a movie, by the way, before everybody gets all fucking uptight about that. Richard Pryor wrote on that. And he was actually supposed to be the lead in that. And then they went with the other actor. And I don't know any of the actors' names. Okay. Number three, Bill, you asked for movie lines said by a non-movie star actress that your listeners' friends talked about. For my group of friends, it's a line from Ghostbusters when Peter Venkman, Bill Murray, shows up to Dana's W. Weaver apartment right after the dog monster runs loose from Louis Tully. I've never seen that movie. I've never seen Ghostbusters. I'm just not a sci-fi guy. Is that considered sci-fi? Venkman shows up to the scene and asks a cop, "What happened?" And the cop nonchalantly replies, "Some moron brought a cougar to a party and it went berserk."
Hey, what happened?
Some moron brought a cougar to a party and it went berserk.
My friends and I have been quoting that cop for years. Check it out at 2:30 of the following. Oh, I can look at these. I can click on the links. This is even better. Why have me read it when I can click on the links? All right, we'll compare my read.
Come on, boys. The way you lollygagging around here with them picks and them shovels, you'd think it was 120 degrees. Can't be more than 114. When you was slaves, you sang like birds. Come on, how about a good old nigger work song?
Jesus Christ, what the fuck kind of link are you sending me here? I thought that was going to go to your fucking... Oh, boy. Am I going to have an apology video here? What the fuck just happened? Do I do this other one? This is my...
How you doing? Why don't you have some of the brie? It's at room temperature. You think it's too warm in here for the brie?
Willis, I'm going home.
Don't leave yet.
All right, fuck all these things. These things are going to be too long, and evidently they have the N-word in them. Oh, boy. Do I need to take a knee after this one? All right, number four. I have two unknown and unheralded actors with memorable movie lines. Both are the great Mel Brooks movies. The first one is The Roman Soldier in the History of the World, Part 1. The Empress is approaching, but there's a horse and a carriage in the way. The Roman soldier looks directly at the camera and says, "Move that miserable piece of shit."
Move that miserable piece of shit.
The over-the-top way he delivers the line comes out of nowhere. I say it all the time, and the best impression I can do. You know what I got to do? I have to get the actual clips for this to work.
Take a look at this gun right here. It's a 45. Stinker stomp a fucking elephant driving a truck and the truck too.
Nicky's here was a neighborhood thief.
Check it out.
His mother called him Zero because she said he would never amount to nothing.
Yeah, but it's too big. Where are you going to hide? All right,
then you probably want this one.
Oh,
right,
about that a mile away. You need this.
Oh,
what the fuck?
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Don't point the gun, Nicky.
Got on safety. What am I going to kill you guys?